Again, I welcome you all, and we are going to start this presentation. The topic for today is the significance of milk in your diet according to Ayurveda, and we will consider the significance of milk in IBDs and many chronic disorders. So we will be focusing mainly on lactose intolerance and milk allergy. So let's get started. Today we will be covering some of the topics. First and foremost, we will go what is the significance of milk according to Ayurveda. Then what is the nutritional profile of milk? What are the changes that are present in the packaged milk that we are just commonly using or drinking on a day-to-day basis? And we will go in depth about lactose intolerance, milk allergy. We will also know about yogurt, buttermilk and whey, and how these could be used in different types of autoimmune disorders, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease and celiac disorders. And also this will give you some hint about how these can be utilized in IBS and other chronic disorders. So this is going to be very interesting, and if you have some query, you can definitely write me here. So getting started, if you consider Ayurveda, wherever there is word used milk, it signifies cow's milk. Even though there are other types of milk that are described in Ayurveda and their properties are also described in detail, but when simply milk is written, it signifies cow's milk. And if you see the properties of the cow's milk, you will find that it is sweet in taste. It is having a cooling effect on the system or entire body. And it is having a mild or soft nature, and it is heavy to digest. When you are drinking lot of milk, then it is heavy to digest. And it is having a dull effect, a slowing effect on the body immediately after drinking it. It is containing fat, so it is naturally unctuous, smooth and dense also. It is having a quality of sliminess or stickiness that is related with the kapha increasing effect. And one of the great thing, it is helpful to induce composure of mind, peace of mind, tranquility of mind. So these are important qualities of cow milk, or generally these are found in all sorts of milk with some like little bit of difference here and there. And if you see what are the activities of the milk, what are the benefits of the milk when we are consuming milk on a regular basis, Ayurveda tells that cow milk, it enhances ojas, the vital essence that is important for immunity, vitality, longevity. It improves your lifespan, the quality and like duration of the life. And then it is very good for promoting intelligence, strength of body. It is a mild laxative. Some people, they are having constipating effect, but generally it is having mild laxative property. It is not of that type of laxative property that will be affecting most of the people in a negative way. It is just very natural. And then of course, you can, if some lady is breastfeeding, it helps to improve lactation. These are some of the activities, some of the benefits when you are consuming milk. Then, according to classical Ayurveda, milk is beneficial in chest injuries. Whether it is simply some injury or there is some internal bleeding, it is helpful in those conditions. Then, if someone is feeling tiredness or experiencing weakness, milk is very good for those. Then there are some pitta-based characteristics like dizziness, delirium, and excess of thirst, hunger, and chronic fever and inflammation. In all these pitta type of properties, milk is very beneficial. And there is another one, like if someone is intoxicated, he or she has taken a lot of alcohol, Then next day they can take buttermilk. It is having some effect to neutralize the intoxication. So it is also related with the pitta. Then it is suggested in urinary problems and very importantly in bleeding problems, in disorders that are related with rakta and pitta. We call these simply rakta pitta or bleeding disorders. So that's why if you have autoimmune disorders like inflammatory bowel disease and you are able to tolerate milk, then it will be a great addition in your diet. If you consider the dosage or the Ayurveda dosa profile of the milk, you will find that it is balancing, it is neutralizing excess of the vata and pitta, and it is enhancing kapha. So definitely, whenever there is some conditions that are kapha dominant, we do not use milk or we simply modify it. And it should not be utilized in acute inflammations, acute fever, indigestion condition. And of course, there are many different ways to utilize milk after modifying its properties with some of the herbs. We will also know about them here. Now, if you consider the Ayurvedic viewpoint of milk, you will find that this is a great food. Actually, this is superfood. But there are some precautions. When even in India, when in the metro cities we are having packaged milk, so it becomes very important. And if you just try to search over the if you try to search in Western countries about milk, you will find that two words are very common. The grass-fed cow, cows in the pasture. What does it signify? I want to tell you that it is some time back, like maybe 10 years, 20 years, or more than 20 years back, some of the big companies they tried to fed cow with non-vegetarian food, non-vegetarian supplements, and they wanted that in this way cows will be producing more milk and it will be beneficial for them from commercial point of view. But these are the things that you can never think in India. Yes, when I say India, if you consider the large population of Hindus, most of them will never eat cow's meat. It is from religious point of view, but they have a general reverence toward the cow, and it is not treated like people are treating in big dairies or big just companies. So cows, whenever they are present in villages with farmers, they are always treated like a member of the family. They are well fed, they are taken care of in a very good way. Personally, you can say I'm a little bit biased also. I'm brought up in an area where just like there is plenty of milk and we used to just drink milk. We used to eat different types of dairy products like yogurt on a daily basis. And I'm saying myself a little bit biased also because when I traveled European countries, I gave consultations. I used to stay in hotels. And then in very good hotels, if I requested that please give me milk and just add little bit of ginger, cinnamon or turmeric if they have, then it will be very good. And they, in most of the conditions, they served me this milk in the breakfast. And I'm really grateful like for all those incidences. And there, some of my friends, they teased me that he is a milk vaidya, he's loving milk. So that's why I'm saying I'm little bit personally biased. But if you go through the entire presentation, you will find lot of things that are based upon clinical researches, clinical facts. And that's why just I'm not of the viewpoint that if you ask me milk is good for me or not, I give my personal opinion. My personal opinion is definitely based upon studies of Ayurveda, study of modern researches, and personal experience with clients. I am guiding them on a one-to-one basis also. So you will not find actually this very much biased. But personally, if I get a chance to drink milk anywhere in the world, I will accept it. Now we come to the nutritional profile of the milk. If you see, this is one of the best source of calcium. It is able one glass of milk, about 240 ml or 250 ml, it is able to provide you 28% of daily requirement of calcium. And this is perhaps the only food item that is able to provide this much calcium, and the calcium is very good. If you consider some other green leafy vegetables like kolar, and in India we have bathwa, methi, sarso, all these like green leafy vegetables, these are having very good quantity of minerals, calcium also. But calcium is present in those vegetables in the form of oxalates, and our body is not able to utilize that oxalate in the same way it is able to utilize calcium from milk and yogurt. That's why if you consider milk as the best source of calcium, it is definitely so. Then if you see, it is having lot of other minerals also. Magnesium, it is having 6%, one glass is providing you 6% of the magnesium. Phosphorus, very good, 22%. Potassium, 10%. Sodium is not, like, I do not consider it. And then zinc, 7%. And selenium, it is providing, one glass of milk is providing 13% of the selenium. If you consider different types of vitamins, milk is very rich in vitamin A, vitamin D, and some of the B vitamins like riboflavin, vitamin B5 and B12. These are all very important, and milk is able to provide you these vitamins. And definitely milk is containing very good quality of fat, and it is very, very beneficial for the entire body. As I was going through different researches, I found that researches have supported the use of milk in obesity. Yes, it was surprising to me, in obesity and in metabolic syndrome, metabolic disorders like hypertension, high blood cholesterol level, it is that good. And if you consider calorie value, it is not providing you a lot of calories. And all the calories, these are from like fat, protein and carbohydrate. There is a good mix of it. And we are coming to proteins. One glass of milk provides you about 8 gram of the protein, roughly 16% of your daily requirement. And if you see different types of amino acids, these are present in a very well balanced manner. Now, carbohydrate, this is the main culprit, and you can say that lactose intolerance is closely associated with carbohydrate. And one glass of milk is providing you 12.8 gram of sugar, but this is not normal sugar, this is lactose. And if you read about milk, you will find that most of the people, they are talking about lactose intolerance and milk allergy, and we will go into very depth about lactose intolerance. And definitely we will consider some points about the milk allergy as well. If you consider lactose, it is a kind of carbohydrate that is having two molecules, one molecule of glucose, one molecule of galactose. And lactose is digestible in small intestine by lactase enzyme. Lactase is the enzyme that is breaking lactose into glucose and galactose, then these are absorbed in the bloodstream and then metabolized. And if you consider, this is just, I want to little bit zoom here, and just give me, yes. Now I like to present you this like diagram this picture by Food Intolerance Network. It is very important. If you see the green part, like all the shades of green, these are the countries where lactose intolerance is not present, particularly North America and European countries. And rest of the part, which is in blue color, blue shades, it is having lactose intolerance. Some of the scientists, they say that very long back, maybe just tens of thousands of years back, there had been one significant mutation, and that affected the expression of the gene that is responsible for production of lactase after 5 years of age. Yes. So this diagram signifies like the two groups of the population. The green part, it is signified that there is presence of lactase in their body throughout their life, and they call it lactase persistence. And the in the blue part, you see the countries or the geographical areas where people are generally having lactose intolerance. But when I went into more depth about it, it is true, and it is having some basis in the genetics and genetic like expression of the gene. And scientists found that they are not able to understand the underlying region of lactase persistence through genetic change only. It is very difficult, and these are all scientific studies. And these are two words. Lactose persistence means the presence of lactase in the body throughout life, and lactose intolerance means the absence of the lactase enzyme after a certain age, or reduction in the secretion of the lactase enzyme, so that people are having lactose intolerance. But many researchers, they tell that this change does not, however, explain all the variation in lactase expression. It is very important to not hear the word lactase expression. Even though some people, they are having like gene that is producing lactase, but it is not very well expressed. It is very important, lactase expression. If you go into more depth, you will find, and I will be giving you a lot of evidence here about it, lactose intolerance doesn't mean that you can't have lactose at all. Yes, many people, they consider that I have lactose intolerance, so I cannot take milk or any of the dairy products at all. This is not scientific. And if you see these two things, you will find that many times lactase secreting cells, these are not exercised when you are avoiding milk totally. You consider it like it, many persons, they are avoiding milk or dairy products for a long time. And in their small intestine, the lactase enzyme, it is not secreted because it is not required when we are not consuming lactose. So under that condition, even though the potential to secrete lactase is present in the body, but it is not expressed because we do not require it. And if you are in such a condition that you are avoiding milk and dairy products for a long time, then there will be problem with the secretion of lactase whenever you take like milk or some other dairy products in sufficient quantity. So if you consider another point here, scientists found that persons who have lactose intolerance, they are like clinically they are having lactose intolerance, even they are able to tolerate 12 to 15 gram of lactose in one serving. When I say 12 gram, it means one glass of milk or 2 to 3 glass of yogurt. This is very significant serving of the milk and yogurt as well. And in entire day, people are able to tolerate very well 18 to 24 gram of lactose. This is not about healthy persons. This is about the persons who are having lactose intolerance. And it is all scientific data. I have given the reference below and anybody just can check it. Now, I want to tell you how lactose intolerance test is conducted in the pathology laboratory. They give you 50 gram of lactose mixed with water and you drink it. Then they are testing the presence of hydrogen in your breath. The second way to check the blood glucose level, and third way is to check the lactic acid levels in the stool. One, two, or all the three methods, these can be combined. There is another method that is rarely used. It is through biopsy of the small intestine, but it is very rare and generally it is never used. So these are different tests, but there is one disparity, one doubt that many of the experts are putting. If most of the people, like if I asked you to drink 1 liter of milk immediately, definitely you will not be able to tolerate it because it is having many other like nutrients besides lactose. But when you are taking 50 gram of lactose, it is roughly about taking 1 liter of milk, and this is not natural even for persons who are drinking milk regularly on a daily basis. So this is the problem with the lactose intolerance test. And what are the symptoms of lactose intolerance? These are very simple symptoms, very common symptoms like gas, bloating, cramps. Sometimes there can be diarrhea. In some persons, they are reporting constipation also. Usually, if you see, these are all the symptoms that are associated with poor digestion. There are many gastrointestinal problems, many very normal conditions that are also having these symptoms. These are not very specific or characteristic of lactose intolerance. Now, I want to just tell you some very interesting studies. So we go into more detail. How can you deal with lactose intolerance? And this is not what I am suggesting personally. This is what researchers have suggested long way back. This study is published in a European journal in 2009, and it tells that if we are able to take some of the lactase from outside, one thing, if we are able to take yogurt or other probiotics in our diet, second item, if somehow we are able to delay the transit of milk or dairy products from stomach to intestine, third item, and if we are able to consume lactose on a daily basis, these are the four things that they found that these four are very helpful for persons who are having lactose intolerance. Next, this study tells that if you are taking yogurt, it is having some of the auto-digesting feature of lactose. Yes. Many of the healthy bacteria that are present in yogurt, they are able to digest lactose. And second good thing, if you compare the presence of lactose in milk and yogurt, you will find that yogurt is having 1/3 the amount of lactose. Yes, one cup, one glass of milk is providing you 12.8 gram of lactose, whereas one cup or one glass of yogurt is providing you about 4 gram of lactose. This is significantly low. And even then, the bacteria that are present in yogurt, they are able to auto-digest the yogurt. So it is very well tolerated, even in persons who are lactase deficient. Pay attention to the red. Very well tolerated by persons who are lactase deficient. It means that persons who are not able to tolerate milk at all, they are able to tolerate yogurt very well. Next study, it tells that the comparison between flavored yogurt and plain yogurt or unflavored yogurt. When you are taking plain yogurt, it is not having any of the sugar, none of the fruits, all that, then it is very good for lactose intolerant persons. It is very well just accommodated by those persons. In next study, you can see one difference in milk and yogurt. Milk is like a fluid, but yogurt is having a gel-like or semi-solid consistency. And this is what is slowing down the gastric emptying of the yogurt. If I'm drinking a glass of milk, then it is going down very rapidly from stomach to the small intestine. But if I'm drinking a cup of yogurt, then it stays inside the stomach for longer time. And this is what is meant by slow gastric emptying of the yogurt. There is another way. If you are consuming milk with some bread or some other preparation, then you are also exerting same effect on the milk. There is another study. It is also very important. Persons who are having regular intake of lactose, they are able to have some adaptation inside their gastrointestinal tract, and they are better able to tolerate lactose in their diet. So these are all the studies, and these are primarily done, carried out in persons who are having some sort of lactose intolerance. So we move to the next one. How to deal with lactose intolerance? These are some of the suggestions, and you can follow these. First one, if you are lactose intolerant and you want to take milk, you have to start with homemade yogurt or even kefir. These are just very good probiotic food, and you can start with them. And definitely, as I told you, yogurt is having about 1/3 of the lactose than milk as compared to milk, and it is very well tolerated. And there are many other health benefits when you are taking yogurt. These are due to the probiotic effect of the yogurt. The second point, if you are starting with milk, do not go for 1 glass of milk. Start with 1/4 cup of milk, then you gradually increase it. And there are other methods, there are other ways of using meals that are very good. Very recently, I got a mail from some person, and he told me that he is lactose intolerant, or he's having milk allergy right from birth. Yes, right from birth. Doctors found that he was having milk allergy right from birth, and he was not able to just have mother's milk also. So that person is able to tolerate a small quantity of milk when he is taking it with turmeric. So there are some different ways of taking milk in this way. You can use turmeric powder, you can boil it with milk, and you can add cardamom. Cardamom is very good if you are having hyperacidity or some other types of pitta problems. Then persons who are having metabolic syndrome, high blood pressure or diabetes or high blood sugar levels or high cholesterol levels, they can take cinnamon and turmeric together. And persons who are having IBDs, inflammatory bowel disease, celiac disease, ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease, they can prefer turmeric and nutmeg. And generally, if you like, you can take holy basil with milk also. Boil holy basil leaf with milk and you just consume it. So the condition is, if you are having lactose intolerance, you start with 1/4 cup of the milk. This is the way. And then you start with 1/4 cup of milk and gradually you increase it. There is another way to take the milk. It is trying buttermilk. This is diluted yogurt. Yes, diluted yogurt, and they remove the butter from the yogurt also. It is having very little fat, and in India, particularly in South, like South Indian states, you will find that they are serving buttermilk. We call it takra in Ayurveda, and this is the same word that is used in South India also. And they are serving like food with diluted buttermilk, and also add some salt, cumin, and mint to it. You can add different types of herbs, and it is very good when you take it with meals. And Ayurveda recommend that it is always a great addition to your diet when you are taking takra or buttermilk in gastrointestinal disorders. Yes, in all these conditions, inflammatory bowel disease, celiac disease, IBS, it is very good if you are taking diluted buttermilk in this way. And it is not heavy at all, because it is not having like any type of fat, very little quantity of fat is present in buttermilk. Next, lactose-free milk, it is also available. It is also good for many persons who are having lactose intolerance to the highest degree. And simply, milk manufacturers, they are adding some lactase enzyme. They are processing milk with lactase enzyme, and it is breaking the lactose sugar into glucose and galactose. So in this way, it is not technically having lactose. But you see, if you drink lactose-free milk, you will find it slightly sweeter than the normal milk. The consistency and taste, all other things, it will be almost similar, just slightly sweeter than the normal milk. There is another very important consideration, and it is related with persons who have IBD and celiac disorder. It is about secondary lactose intolerance. It might be the condition that many persons who have these disorders, these are not lactose intolerant primarily. They might be able to use milk or yogurt when they do not have symptoms, or the symptoms are in very mild condition, if inflammation is in very mild condition. But when the disease becomes aggressive, then they develop lactose intolerance. This is very common, and it is like termed as secondary lactose intolerance, because this is not primarily found in those persons. And what is the reason for it? Because all these disorders, whether celiac disease or inflammatory bowel disease, these are affecting the intestinal mucosa, the inner lining of the small intestine and large intestine. When the part that is producing lactase, it is having some malfunctioning, it is not able to produce lactase, then definitely any person who is not lactose intolerant, otherwise he can develop lactose intolerance. But the good thing is that if that person is in remissive state, the symptoms, they gradually, inflammation that becomes better, then definitely they are having relief in the lactose intolerance also. In this condition, I generally suggest, and there is one more research that is very relevant here, and it was found in relation with gluten allergy, gluten sensitivity, or you can say celiac disease. And it is true for all the other inflammatory bowel disease as well. All those persons who are having these conditions, many times they are taking anti-inflammatory drugs for a long time. They are also taking sometimes steroids or strong immunosuppressant drugs. So under all that condition, there is a high probability of having many side effects due to medical drugs. And there are some other conditions that can be developed. And it is very common. I have seen many of these in my clients who have IBDs. One of them is compromised gallbladder function and motility. Second one is pancreatic insufficiency. Third one is increased gut permeability. Fourth one is small intestinal bowel overgrowth. And last one, it is very important. It is non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Even the person, they are not taking alcohol in any form, but they are developing fatty liver. And lactose intolerance and milk allergy. I have told you that many times lactose intolerance and milk allergy, it is secondary in nature. It is not primary. It is caused by all these disorders. Now, I like to briefly touch the milk allergy. It is allergic reaction to the milk proteins. And what are the symptoms? Very common nausea, vomiting, gas, bloating, diarrhea after taking milk. These are found in lactose intolerance as well. Then the last group of symptoms is very important. These persons do have skin rashes, urticaria. Sometimes there can be breathing problem. And when there is some heaviness in the throat area and breathing problem, this is the time when you need to have some urgent or immediate medical care. This is a rare like anaphylactic reaction due to the milk allergy, and all these symptoms, these are not limited to the milk. Whenever some person is having food allergy, any type of food allergy, definitely all these symptoms are present in that also. And whenever some person is having allergic reaction to certain medical drugs, again these symptoms are very much there. So these are not specific symptoms of the milk allergy, but you know that these are present when someone is having milk allergy. And milk allergy is confirmed only after allergy test. Doctors just have a prick on the skin and they introduce some milk proteins. They keep it there for a period of 24 to 48 hours. And if there is a small blister or inflammation at that point, then there is probability of having milk allergy. But many persons, they are misinformed. So if they like drink milk or have some other dairy products and they feel little bit discomfort, they start to say that we have milk allergy. This is not true. Milk allergy is always has to be diagnosed. And even persons who are having milk allergy, they can tolerate yogurt and buttermilk in a very good way, very comfortably. They are able to tolerate buttermilk and yogurt. There are some other considerations that are related with milk. I will not go into detail, but two or three just are very prominent here. It is the large scale farming and dairy industry. Earlier, these were not very well organized. But in developing countries, you will find that dairy industry is huge. In Denmark or other countries, just very small countries, but they have a huge dairy industry. So when it is all very, very commercial, then they can go to any length to produce more milk. They can have genetic modification in the cows, then they can use different types of like food. And I told you about the condition mad cow's disease. Dairy industry just tried to feed cows with non-vegetarian food in a way just to produce more milk, and then the cows had mad cow disease, and the hundreds or thousands of cows have to be sought in this way. So these are two big pitfalls. And third one is homogenization of milk in tetra packs. Homogenization milk, when you consider milk, it is a colloidal solution. It is not a homogeneous mixture. It is not a like solution at all. There are some particles that are small, water particles, some big fat globules are there. So when you homogenize milk, you are just disrupting the natural structure of the milk, and then you have better shelf life. Even if you are not refrigerating it, it will be good for weeks and months. The fourth one here is reconstituted milk and buttermilk. I have seen it in India also by some of the prominent companies. They are writing on buttermilk packet that it is reconstituted. I do not know whether I can call it actually milk or buttermilk. So, just you understand this condition that when they are having reconstituted milk or buttermilk, it is not milk or buttermilk, whatever you call it, but certain regulations they are allowing it. And I don't want to just go into more detail about these. And what is my advice about persons who are having IBDs or chronic celiac disease? If someone is having aggressive stage where there are 4 to 5 plus bowel movements and sometimes there is bleeding also, they can avoid milk. They can, if they are taking it regularly, they can minimize milk intake during aggressive phase of inflammatory bowel disease. But they can, even if it is aggressive and if they are able to take like diet orally, most of the persons they are able to feed themselves. So during that condition, they can take buttermilk or yogurt 1 to 2 serving a day. Yes, this is sufficient. Another condition is improving somewhat. It is mild stage, 3 to 4 bowel movements are there, then they can start milk intake very gradually. Start with 1/4 cup and increase it after like 2 or 3 weeks, and you continue with buttermilk and yogurt 1 to 2 serving. Further, like there is improvement in mild stage. There is very less inflammation, 1, 2, or 3 bowel movements, and there is no bleeding at all and minimal symptoms. You can start to have milk, and it is always better to start gradually and to use milk with spices like turmeric powder or nutmeg. These two are very good for conditions like IBDs. And definitely, you can have buttermilk and yogurt. Overall, it will be better if you have 2 to 3 servings a day of either milk and yogurt and buttermilk. So you combine all the three. So this is a very good way to start with it. Now, if some persons who are having milk allergy, I suggest them to avoid milk totally, and they can start with buttermilk, small quantities first, and buttermilk or yogurt they can. And I have just like some clients who are contacting me and they are able to tolerate it. So they start with buttermilk and yogurt. It is having proteins, milk proteins in some altered form. So if you do not have any problem with buttermilk and yogurt, you continue them, and very gradually you introduce milk, 1/4 cup of milk. If you are able to tolerate it, like continue for 2 to 3 weeks and then increase it. If you are not able to tolerate even 1/4 cup of milk, thus you can avoid. And it will be better if you take 1/4 cup of milk with turmeric powder, because it is having in itself some of the anti-allergic and anti-inflammatory property, so it will be very good. So persons who are having milk allergy, they should also receive. It is not just for the persons who are having milk allergy, it is true for persons who are having any type of food allergy. And I have just found the combination of some of the herbs to be very helpful in milk allergy. This is Ayur Normally or My Active Liver. These are the tablets for liver health, liver detox. Ayur Shodhan, body detox and colon cleansing tablet. And sometimes when there are rashes, some allergic problems, then I give Ayur Kanti. So the regimen of these 2 or 3 herbs, these are very good for dealing with any type of food allergy, including milk allergy. And finally, I wish you all to have vibrant health and just stay healthy, stay blessed, and adopt Ayurveda and yoga in your life. It will be very good for you. And thank you. Namaste. If you have some queries regarding this topic, you can write me. If you want me to cover some other topic, do write in the comment. I will take care of that. Thank you. Namaste.